Hello and welcome back to the Stationery Dev. Today we are taking a look at a pen from Platinum. Now, I really love Platinum. This one was a little bit of an impulse buy for me a few years ago. I believe I bought it either on Fountain Pen Day or Black Friday one year. I believe I bought it from Pen Chalet. I don't remember for sure. I love Platinum pens though, and I couldn't resist a good price on a celluloid one. So this is the Platinum 3776 Century model, but it's in their celluloid finishes, which is sort of a special line that they do. I don't know if they're still producing them, but you can still find them new out there. And really unique pen. So let's get right into it. Platinum is one of, if not the only company that's still manufacturing sort of celluloid pens, I think. And they're making the celluloid themselves and everything like that. It's not your typical sort of solid rod of celluloid, though. Interestingly enough, the way they make this celluloid is, I believe it's like a sort of like a laminating process where they're laying pieces of celluloid on like thin pieces on top of each other and making like a sheet, and then they roll that sheet and make it into what we have here is the pen. I believe that's the process, but I'm not 100% sure, but I just know it's not the solid sort of rod of celluloid that you used to find. They have a variety of different celluloids available. This one is the Jade celluloid, and let me just give you a close-up of that. It is absolutely gorgeous. There's, I don't know if the camera can really capture it, but there is just sort of this depth to the finish, and it's just one of those pens that I can stare at this thing for hours without even using it. Or if while I'm using it, I might get distracted just staring at this pen. It is absolutely stunning. I love this finish. But they have tons of finishes. They're all really nice. They have a blue one that's similar to this one. They have like a pink. It's almost like the old snakeskin kind of celluloid. They have a koi one, calico, tortoiseshell. They have some really, really nice finishes. So I think there's something sort of for everybody in terms of the finishes that they offer. But this one I just couldn't pass up. It is absolutely stunning, gorgeous finish. This sort of style, as far as the style goes, it's sort of a standard Platinum styling. Let me get a 3776 just so we can kind of compare the two, because there are some key differences here. All right, so as you can see with this pen, it has the same sort of Platinum styling. If you maybe you just saw this by itself, you'd assume it's the same exact, you know, thing as this 3776. It's got the rounded sort of ends to it. It's got the standard Platinum clip there. Functional, works good, not too tight, not too loose. The ring around the outside, nothing special either. Japan 3776 Platinum on it. But if we bring in a regular 3776, you might notice a couple differences. First of all, if I line them up here at the end, you'll see that the, maybe you won't as good, but you'll see that the regular one is just a little bit longer. And I think the biggest difference is you'll see that the regular 3776 is also a little bit wider than the celluloid version. Now, with the cap off, the difference is a lot less drastic. We take the caps off of both. You can see that they're practically the same. The length is a lot closer, as you can see there. Try to get them lined up. Yeah, I mean, it's maybe a millimeter or two difference in terms of length, but the real difference is the width of it. You can see that the 3776 celluloid doesn't have this extra step here that the regular 3776 has, and I think that's what gives it its sort of extra width. This one is just stays straight on the threads. There's no step up or anything after the threads. So that's sort of the main difference. This one has a little bit more bling around the section, but doesn't have the bling on the end there. So just a little minor differences. As you can see, the nibs are exactly the same, so nothing special in the nib department there. So let me put this other one away. And we'll look at here. Now the other difference too is that this pen uncaps in one rotation. There you go, which is a little bit shorter than the other, the regular version, which uncaps in 1 3/4 turns. So it's 3/4 of a turn quicker to uncap, which you might like. It's also missing the slip and seal mechanism, which may or may not be a deal breaker for you, I don't know. But I haven't noticed it drying out anymore or anything like that. It just might not last years or whatever the slip and seal claims to do for it, but it doesn't have that slip and seal mechanism, so they had to cut that out for whatever reason. But it does have a plastic insert in there that helps keep the nib locked off and dry and wet. Not the smoothest threads in terms of uncapping. You can see the threads are, you know, cut into the celluloid there, and they're, let me see if I can get it focused for you. And they're cut into the celluloid in the cap there. But it's not the smoothest threads. It's here. You can hear it kind of squeaking, which, I mean, I don't think is really a problem other than it just doesn't feel as good as it could, I guess. It does have the thinner, sort of smaller section, I think, than the regular 3776. So it is a little bit of a smaller, shorter, slightly shorter pen, but definitely thinner pen. So maybe if you don't like small pens, maybe this one might be a little too small for you, maybe not. It does post well, so maybe consider posting it. It does add a little bit more weight to it, but it does give it a more comfortable length, I think. But I still use this one unposted because it's good enough for me. Like I said, the same exact nib as the 3776. They have 3776 platinum, 14 karat gold. This is a broad nib that I got in this one, which is something out of the ordinary, but I actually really like this broad nib. And we'll sort of get to that, but it's not, for me, it's not overly wet or not, you know, a gusher or fire hose, but it has a nice controlled flow to it. It has the same exact feed as the 3076 and everything as well, just a little bit shorter of a section. So you'll see when we open this up, the converter kind of sticks out a little bit farther. It goes right up to, you know, the threads there, the converter does. But it has the standard converter for platinum. Take it or leave it, but that's what it comes with. Nothing fancy, but it does have one thing to note, though. Like a lot of Japanese pens, for some reason, they have these metal sections going on to the plastic or celluloid or whatever you want to call it, threads on the inside. So Japanese pens, for whatever reason, don't have that fear of wear and tear there, but just something to note. Now, for what we're going to ink this with, I have a sample here that I need to use, that I need to try at least, from Van S. This is PenBBS number 342 Matcha Ice Cream. This is a hard ink to come by, but it's one I've been wanting to try for a long time. It's sort of in that color of green that I really like, that sort of matcha color. For me, I really like that color, so this one might be a real winner, which would be a shame because I'd have to track it down in China somewhere. It'd probably be really hard to find. But that's what we're going to use and see if it's any good. So new ink experience for me. Old pen or pen I've used a while. And I'm going to try to do this without spilling it absolutely everywhere. Gentle. Should get some ink in here. We'll do two runs. Down and back up. I didn't do so great on that second one, but it looks like we got a pretty full fill. Either way. And napkin time, which my napkin has disappeared. Here we go. Nice matcha color. It looks like, you know, I just spilt some matcha there, some matcha tea. So, I mean, as far as accuracy of color goes, it's pretty spot on so far, at least on the napkin. Alright, we're gonna screw this back on. Interestingly enough, the metal on plastic threads are a lot smoother than the plastic on plastic threads. So, I don't know, maybe that's why they make that decision, I don't know. And we're gonna throw this cap back on. I'd say maybe we got a milliliter of ink in there. It's hard to tell with the sample because the label's kind of over it. Now, on to the writing sample, which I had a sheet Rhodia paper here. I'm going to get you a little bit closer so we can see. How the pen writes, because a pen's not a pen if it doesn't write well. All right, we have the platinum. 3776. Century. Celluloid. And this is in the jade. Has a 14 karat gold broad nib. Don't pay attention to the color here. That's just a little bit of a little bit of ink left over from whatever I had it inked with last time. It's kind of got an orangey start, but there's the color of the ink, which so far it's actually really wet, and I really like that color. It's similar to something like Alt Gold Grün, but I think it's more green, but it's in that same sort of family. The ink we have here is PenBBS 342 Matcha Ice Cream. Like I said, coming out really wet, really smooth. I do really like the color. Once again, that's a shame because I might not be able to get a hold on a, you know, hand on a bottle. In terms of wetness, as you can see, it's a broad nib, but that's still pretty wet, but not uncontrollably wet. Like, it's not off the charts, which is what I like about this broad nib. Even with a wet ink like this one, it's not uncontrollable. It's not, you know, going to be bleeding or feathering on everything. It's still a very controlled, even flow for me. Let's get on to the sentence. You can kind of listen. Alright, five boxing wizards jump quickly. Good line. Very smooth. So, if you're afraid of platinum's sort of toothiness or feedback or anything, this one might be a good option for you because it is extremely smooth. It just has some audible feedback, but more like marker feedback, not like pencil feedback. So, if you it's kind of like you're writing with a marker, like a felt tip marker or something. It doesn't have like the typical, you know, toothiness or anything like that that you might expect some of the finer nibs from platinum. Very smooth, wet, but what I like is it's wet and controlled flow. You can see shading with it, you can see sheen with it, but it's not out of hand. Very wet, controlled, even flow. Great pen. It's just a really good nib. I'm not usually one for broad nibs, but Pilot, man, it's a day. Platinum's broad nibs are actually really, really nice for me. As far as the line goes, I mean, I've had some Western mediums that are about this thickness, so I think it's sort of maybe a Western medium, or maybe between a Western medium and a broad. So just keep that in mind. It's not going to be as broad as, you know, maybe something like a Pelican broad is. And the color of this ink is fantastic. There's no, maybe there's a little bounce with this nib, with the platinums. But it's not super noticeable. They're usually pretty firm nibs. There's no line variation, so there's no point in pushing it. Like, there's pressure and there's no pressure, and it's the exact same line. This one's just a little bit more wet. Has a little bit more ink coming out there. Same exact line, but it's really comfortable. It's a well-balanced pen, even though it's a shorter pen. It's well-balanced in my hand. It feels great. I could write a long time with this pen. So no complaints or anything from the pen there. Now, terms of price. These come in a range, sort of depending on, once again, where you buy them, what country you're buying them from. Is it from a retailer? Are they new? Are they used? Like I said, it's getting hard to find new ones of the celluloids. But like I've seen a range of anywhere from $200 on eBay to about $400 from a retailer. I think it's worth it if you want a sort of a new celluloid pen, you know, a newly manufactured new celluloid being made, that kind of pen. And if you're a fan of platinums, you love the 3776, you want something unique and something different and something that's just absolutely stunningly gorgeous, this one, I think, is worth the price that it comes with. Because a regular 376 is what, up to almost $200 now, new. And so to get this lovely finish and everything in the same sort of package is really a good buy for me. I wouldn't buy it if you don't like small pens, or if you're not a fan of, you know, platinum nibs or anything like that. It is a smaller pen. It is a platinum still. It has that same nib and styling and everything. But if you do love platinums, if you love the styling, if you like a smaller package, and if you love celluloid unique finishes, this one, I think, is worth it and a very good buy if you can find it. I absolutely love it. I'm mesmerized by it. I'm a fan of platinum, love their nibs, so it's a pretty easy sale for me. But that's just me. So I really love this pen. I sort of don't use it as much as I should, I think. But there you go. That's my review of the Platinum 3776 Celluloid in the jade finish. Really beautiful pen. Has a pretty permanent spot in my collection. And yeah, let me know what you think of platinum. If you have a celluloid one, what you think of the finish and everything on it, the size as well. And until next time, I'll catch you later.